Thank you. The Lord is truly risen. Hallelujah. To him be glory and power to all the ages of eternity. Hallelujah, hallelujah. In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Dearly beloved in Christ, this is Easter Sunday. And we are celebrating this Easter in exactly the same way the apostles of Jesus Christ celebrate the very first Easter. They were hiding in their room, in the upper room, for fear not of coronavirus, for fear of those who had killed Jesus Christ. God has taken us back to the drawing board, perhaps through the misfortune of coronavirus. We pray today for God to bring an end to this disease. We pray today for God to heal those who are sick from this disease, so that the Easter's joy will fill the whole earth and bring life back to normal. Let us acknowledge that we are sinners before God as we prepare to celebrate this sacred mystery. Lord Jesus, you are Prince of Peace and Lord of Life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came into the world to cause sinners to repentance. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
For the many times we have sinned against you, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Amen. Glory to God in the highest. And let peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, Only Begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the glory, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who on this day, through your only begotten Son, have conquered death and unlocked for us the path to eternity, grant, we pray, that we who keep the solemnity of the Lord's resurrection may, through the renewal brought by your Spirit, rise up in the light of Christ. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter proceeded to speak and said, "You know what has happened all over Judea, beginning in Galilee after the baptism that John preached, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and power. He went about doing good and healing all those who oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. We are witnesses of all that he did, both in the country of the Jews and in Jerusalem. They put him to death by hanging him on a tree. This man God raised on the third day and granted that he be visible not only to all the people, but to us, the witnesses chosen by God in advance, who ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead. He commissioned us to preach to the people and testify that he is the only one appointed by God as judge of the living and the dead. To him, all the prophets bear witness that everyone who believes in him will receive forgiveness of sins through his name. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia.
Alleluia.
Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his mercy endures forever. Let the house of Israel say, his mercy endures forever.
Alleluia.
The right hand of the Lord has struck with power. The right hand of the Lord is exalted. I shall not die but live and declare the works of the Lord.
Alleluia.
The stone which the builders rejected has become the cornerstone. By the Lord has this been done. It is wonderful in our eyes.
Alleluia.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, do you not know that a little yeast leavens all the dough? Clear out the old yeast so that you may become a fresh batch of dough, inasmuch as you are unleavened. For our Paschal Lamb, Christ has been sacrificed. Therefore, let us celebrate the feast, not with the old yeast, the yeast of malice and wickedness, but with the unleavened bread of sincerity and truth. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah,
hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Christ, our Paschal Lamb, has been sacrificed. Let us then feast with joy in the Lord.
Alleluia. Alleluia. Alleluia.
We have the sequence, the Easter sequence before the Gospel. Victimi Paschali Nodens. Imolam Christiani, admire demis oves, Christus in ocens patri, reconcilia vit peccatores. Mors dat vita duelo, confligere mirandum, ducit emotu. Regna vivus, ignobis Maria, vividis timbiam, sepulchrum Christi viventis, et gloriam vidiris sugentis.
vestes, sudare iubet vestem, surexi Christus pes meam, preacher de suos in Galileam. Timus Christum surexis es, amor tuis vere, tu nobis victorex, miserere. Amen. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
On the first day of the week, Mary of Magdala came to the tomb early in the morning, while it was still dark, and saw the stone removed from the tomb. So she ran and went to Peter, Simon Peter, and to the other disciple whom Jesus loved, and told them, "They have taken the Lord away from the tomb, and we don't know where they put him." So Peter and the other disciple went out and came to the tomb. They both ran, but the other disciple ran faster than Peter and arrived at the tomb first. He went down and saw the burial clothes there, but did not go in. When Simon Peter arrived after him, he went into the tomb and saw the burial clothes there and the cloth that had covered his head, not with the burial clothes, but rolled up in a separate place. Then the other disciple also went in, the one who had arrived at the tomb first, and he saw and believed, for they did not yet understand the scripture that he had to rise from the dead. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear brothers and sisters, I mentioned at the beginning of the Mass, incidentally, if you want to call it an accident of geography and history, you can call it whatever you choose to. But the whole world, beginning from America to Asia to Africa, to Europe, the whole world is celebrating this unique Easter in exactly the same fashion in which the first Easter was celebrated. And how was the first Easter celebrated? There was no pageantry of drinking and making merry, running around and saying hello to friends, having parties around the city. The first Easter, 3 days after Jesus had been buried, the disciples ran into a building and were hiding. Hiding then, not from the coronavirus as we are today. Hiding then, not to cause the spread of an infection. Hiding from the same authorities that killed their master and Lord Jesus Christ. The town was quiet, because there was tragedy that weekend in Jerusalem. And even those who were not believers could not celebrate. They knew an innocent person had been killed innocently. Jesus Christ is a phenomenon. If you don't want to call him God, you can call him a phenomenon, because he is more than a human being. There is a saying in English, that empires rise and fall, and truly so. The only empire that rose and has not fallen is the kingdom of God, the Church of Jesus Christ. It has gone through turbulence, persecution. Many of you will recall or know that for 300 years, not 3 years, 300 years after Christ died and rose from the dead, his disciples, his followers, his believers were persecuted by the powerful Roman Empire. They hunted them and killed them like animals. And yet, the church was not extinguished. The Jews wanted to prove that Jesus would not rise from the dead. It would have been so beautiful for them and fulfilling if after the disciples announced that Jesus had risen, they went to the tomb and brought out his body to show the community. That did not happen. They couldn't find his body in the tomb. That's one evidence. But the most powerful evidence that Jesus had risen is the spirit with which he accompanies the church from one generation to the other. Even non-believers cannot destroy it. Whether you believe in Christ or not, his resurrection is a reality. And when people who don't believe try to work too hard to destroy his body, the church, he visits them with torture. He visits them with conversion. His spirit comes down to force people to believe. In some cases, he doesn't always do it. The biggest example was the big catch of that generation, St. Paul. He led an army that went against the church, killing the believers wherever they were, hunting them down and killing them like chickens. Jesus visited him and said, "Paul, why are you persecuting me?" He chained him, arrested him, and turned his heart into believing in him. And Paul is the greatest Christian that ever lived, my brothers and sisters. Today we have a problem. Today the world has been held hostage, not by kidnappers or hostage takers, but by a virus, a small, simple virus has intimidated world leaders, intimidated people across the world, and everybody is locked up in their homes, thereby celebrating Easter like the very first one in our homes. No parties to attend, even if we wanted to. This goes to show the power of the Spirit of Christ. Nobody could have believed with the development of humanity in science and technology that a virus would cause this much damage. But I can tell you, it is in God's power to push this all away in one day. In one day. And we pray he does it. So today, as we celebrate the resurrection of Christ, the message is clear. The world is in God's hands, and he can do whatever he wants. He can give us joy. He can let us suffer, just like he let his son suffer before the resurrection. And so, my brothers and sisters, the Easter of this year gives us more hope than all the Easters we ever celebrated, that Christ is with us and will pull us out of this darkness. The resurrection shows that there is light shining at the end of the dark tunnel, that all is not lost. Yes, what we are going through can be considered a Good Friday experience. The beauty of it is, even the U.S. and even other nations will rise up from this pain, from this destruction, stronger and bigger than ever before. We Christians will emerge from this pandemic in stronger faith, dedicating ourselves to God. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made, for us men and for our salvation. He came down from heaven by the Holy Spirit, was incarnated of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and life of the world to come. Amen. Brothers and sisters, we pray today to the Lord. Lord, you who live in us, inviting us to be Christ for others, especially those most in need. In gratitude for your victory over death, we offer our prayers and petitions this morning.
For the whole church on this day of the Lord's triumph, that the new resurrection fire kindled at our Easter vigil might spread through the darkness of an unbelieving world with irresistible power. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, as we celebrate and renew in our lives this great mystery, bring peace to our world from selfish power struggles. Heal broken relationships in marriage and friendships. And restore reverence for every human being made in your image and likeness. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That our Holy Father and all bishops, successors to the apostles in the church today, together with your priests, may boldly proclaim the resurrection of Christ and the forgiveness of sins in his name. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That our catechumens may be strengthened in faith by our prayers for them, until the day when they can receive the sacraments of initiation and celebrate the fullness of new life in Christ. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Lord, bring an end to the coronavirus pandemic. Remove our fears and turn our hearts back to you. We pray for those suffering from this terrible virus, especially those isolated from their loved ones, and for the repose of those who have died. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Lord, through the power of your resurrection, grant courage and strength to our healthcare professionals, first responders, and other essential workers who serve us and put their own lives at risk in this difficult time. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Send your Spirit to inspire the efforts of our research scientists and others to find a timely cure and vaccine for COVID-19. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Lord, be close to and renew in hope all those who have lost their jobs and are experiencing financial difficulties. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all who suffer, who grieve, who are distressed in mind and heart, that Jesus, who brought unexpected exaltation to Mary Magdalene and the apostles on that first Easter Sunday, may give them also a share of his rising to new life. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Lord, we pray specially for all those in our parish who have died, and all those among our families and friends who hold dear to us, that they may share in the victory of Christ that in heaven. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Let us pray for all those who have asked for our prayers and those intentions we carry in the silence of our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers. Lord, no words can fathom the awesome mystery of your resurrection. In your faithful love and great mercy, hear and look kindly on these and all our petitions. Through the intercession of your Holy Mother, Saint Joseph, and all the saints, we ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you. Lord, wash away my iniquities, cleanse me from all my sins.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours will be acceptable to God, Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
Exultant with paschal gladness, O Lord, we offer the sacrifice by which your church is wondrously reborn and nourished, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always, at all times, to acclaim you, Lord. But on this day, above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he has destroyed our death. By rising, restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise. And even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Holy, 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 holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Eucharistic prayer number one, the Roman canon. To you, therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for the Holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servant Francis, our Pope, Cordiglione, our Bishop, and all those who hold him to the truth, hand on the Catholic and Apostolic faith. Remember your servants. Now we pray especially for all our loved ones whom we intend to pray at this Mass for. We remember in a special way the victims of coronavirus, the loved ones they left behind, and those who are suffering in isolation and the pain of being isolated. And all who are gathered here, whose faith and devotion are known to you, for them we offer you this sacrifice of praise, or they offer it for themselves, and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls in the hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the Almighty God, living and true. Celebrating this most sacred day on the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ in the flesh, and in communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious Ever Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and our Lord Jesus Christ, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, your apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon and Jude, Linus, Cletus,
Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John and Paul, Cosmas and Damian, all the saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers, in all things we may be defended by your protecting hand, through Christ our Lord. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family, which we make to you. Also for those to whom you have been pleased to give the new birth of water and the Holy Spirit, granting them forgiveness of their sins, order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation, and contented among those flock of those you have chosen, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve these offerings in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, Jesus Christ. On the day he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when the supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more in his holy and venerable hands, once more giving thanks, he said a blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in the memory of me." The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of this blessed passion, the resurrection from the dead, the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ, your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty, from the gifts that you have given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life, and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them, as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing through Christ our Lord. Remember also, Lord, your servants, we pray now, especially for all those who have died within this period of corona pandemic, who have gone before us with the sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace through Christ our Lord. To us also, your servants, who those sinners hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share and fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into the company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon, through Christ our Lord, through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord. You sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us.
Through him, with him, in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by the divine teaching, we dare to pray, our Father,
who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope, the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
The glory
are yours now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, say to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world.
Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. By this most holy body and blood from their sins, we give you faith and teach you ever let me depart from you.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my room, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
Spiritual Communion Prayer. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Happy Easter to everyone, to our dear parishioners, to our dear brothers and sisters in Christ, and also to our friends who had been following us in our live stream events, celebrations, masses, and even processions here at St. Gregory and in the parish. I wish you God's blessing. The risen Christ is indeed resurrected, and he would renew us. That is the message for us for this Easter. May we also be a testimony and witness of renewal for others. In this world, not only in the Catholic Church, not only in the Christian world, but in the whole world, that would need a lot of renewal, and indeed need a lot of Christ being the resurrected and being the one who would give us life. I want to thank you for your support to the parish. I am mindful of many who lost their jobs, loss of income, loss also of their salaries, or unstable what would happen in the next few weeks or the next months. We pray for them. We here at St. Gregory, we are here to support you, and we pray for you every day. We pray also for those who are supporting us here in the parish. We still continue our parish operations. I thank those who can still support the parish, even if we are not gathered here as a congregation on Sundays or in weekly gatherings. I want to thank you, and especially for your patience and understanding in giving to us, whether it be online or you mail your envelopes. Some of you drop off your envelopes to the parish office. Some of you may have a problem on going out to your houses. You can always call the parish and just make a pledge, and we would follow up with you. Our staff are still working. Father Oliver and I are still working during these days. Yes, we go to hospital still to bless and to anoint our brothers and sisters who are very, very ill. Some of our parishioners have died. Unfortunately, we could not do the funeral mass for them here at St. Gregory. We go either to the mortuary place or to the burial site directly and be with the family. Only 10 people are allowed. But I assure them that our love is virtual. Our love also is viral, supporting them and united with them in their grief. I always relay to them your prayerful condolences to our parishioners who are mourning. I would like to assure you also of our daily masses here for your intentions. In a very special way, on behalf of Father Oliver, Deacon Bob, Deacon Sal, all the parish staff, I would like to assure you of our thanks to you in many ways that you are there for the parish. We have a tech minister, Marvin Sanchez. I would like to thank Marvin for always being there. Even in the shelter-in-place order, I was hesitant at first to ask anybody to be a tech minister for us because they are supposed to be in shelter-in-place. But thank God, we have been healthy. Marvin had been healthy. I thank his family, Anna, and the children for sharing with us, Marvin. I thank PFC, ABS-CBN Company for sharing with us and lending with us your tech guy, Marvin. Live streaming and broadcasting our activities. And many of you who had volunteered also, thank you so much. In this also, I would like to announce that after this Mass, I would be processing with Father Oliver around the neighborhood and around the parish to give you the Easter blessing, accompanied by the actual relic of a cross, of the actual cross of our Lord Jesus. His cross is victorious over sin and death, and indeed would always be victorious against any virus that would attack us. May it be our parish's blessing to you. As you cannot come here to Mass, as you cannot come here to this building, Christ is going to you. Christ is visiting you to bless you and give you his Easter blessing. Have a blessed Easter, my dear brothers and sisters and dear parishioners.
Christ, our Passover, has been sacrificed. Hallelujah. Therefore, let us keep the feast that the unleavened bread of purity and truth. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let us pray. Look upon your church, O God, with unfailing love and favor, so that renewed by the Paschal mysteries, she may come to the glory of the resurrection through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Father Mark, our pastor, has said it all and given you appreciation and blessings of Easter, which will be continued around our streets. I want to appreciate Father Mark, also our pastor, for the fraternity we share and for the leadership he's offering us and his presence to us and the community during this very difficult moment. I also, in addition to him, wish all of you a very happy Easter. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you, remain with you now and forever. Go forth, the Mass is ended. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Thanks be to God.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Anymore be an exposition of the Blessed Sacrament today, but instead we'd like to ask all of you to please join us as we do another procession
all around the neighborhood of St. Gregory's Parish. So join us again, so we'll be doing another live feed of the procession. Thank you and happy Easter to all.